Shrisha Reddy now joining us live from Chennai Story. Shrisha, you brought us this ground report talking about how these Tamilians of Lankan origin are in fact living in fear. You've gone and spoken to them. So what can actually be done to help the situation, considering the police is on a severe crackdown currently?
Well, at this point in time, yes, of course, they have been keeping an eye on these Sri Lankan refugees. There are at least like 114 camps in the state, so they have been digging into the details. But what the police is looking at right now is that those people who are not living in these camps, at least 12,000 odd Sri Lankan Tamil refugees are not living in the camps. They do own a passport, so that is one of the reasons that why they have been looking into the details of these Sri Lankan refugees who are outside the camps. So that will be a challenging task for the police ahead, because that is how Arun Selvaraj had got another passport. He had influenced the government offices in Tamil Nadu to get another passport with Sri Lankan and an Indian passport. So that is going to be this crucial point for the intelligence Q branch officials to get into the details of this particular case.
Shrisha Reddy, thank you so much for bringing us that update. We'll continue to track the story as it develops.